Hi. How is everybody doing today? It's Monday and it's almost noon, so it's like lunchtime. Okay. And I'm gonna figure something for you to pick, but today's topic is going to be your person, so this is about your person and their current thoughts and feelings about you. So I want to say pick a person, but not literally. Don't just pick a person. All right, it's got to be your person, someone that's connected to you. And this is they're going to be their current thoughts and feelings about you. Let me see, what do I want you to pick from? I really liked doing the animals. I think I might go with animals again. I liked the animals. I don't remember what I did it on. I think it was the last reading. I don't know. One is the B, obviously. Don't worry, I'll show you too. Oh, I love the dolphin. Option two is the dolphin. How cute. And was option three going to speak for itself, or did I get a pick? Option three doesn't want to tell me nothing. So we're gonna cherry pick option three. So what's option three? Ooh, the golden egg. An animal. I mean, what it'll become, I don't know. It's a random animal. Hummingbird though at the bottom. Okay. Sorry. So option one is going to be the bee. This is for hold up. Your person, okay, current thoughts and feelings about you from your person, okay. This is going to be the B for option one. Option two is the dolphin, okay. And then option three is the golden egg. That's like not even a particular animal. That's like, I don't know what kind of animal that'll be. It's golden, okay. And we have the hummingbird, so that's kind of cool. All right, so go ahead and meet me later with the piles or pick your pick, whichever. I'll see you there. Bye. Okay. So bubbly. Mean, the pun was not intended, but we'll take it. Is that two? One. No, oh my God, don't fall. Oh, the recovery. Oh, it's good. Oh geez, I should not be drinking bubbly. What was I thinking? I have to actually talk for like the next hour. Oh my God, I'm gonna be burping up a storm. That was not wise to drink soda before coming on a camera. My frustration. Interesting. Well, one more towel. Two more towels. I never use this deck. I don't know if anyone's there. I can't even remember the name, but it's part of the same person that makes this deck. The little circles. Kim, well, that is right up here. Kim Kranz, right? What's this one called? It just says tarot. It's this the tarot deck by Kim Kranz. And I never use it. I got it because I wanted to complete the collection. And I just never use it. Woo! I just got an email. I'm expecting some pots in the mail today from Amazon. No, mucho is coming. Mucho caliente. It's just emails. Nothing. I hear something. I thought it was the Amazon guy. They might come while I'm filming. Yeah, I really like the feel of these cards. Ooh, that's a really pretty Empress card. Oh, I love that card. That's true. I have looked at this deck. I mean, I've used it. I just never use it. I don't use it extensively. I hope you can hear me. I'm not talking very loud. Get my windows open. We'll get over that once I actually start pulling out these cards. But till then, I don't know what I was doing. So busy looking at that Empress card. I really love that card. Oof, with a new romantic cycle underneath. What is this topic again? I get so excited myself. Okay, maybe I should start watching television again. This person's current thoughts and feelings about you. Ooh, I'm gonna start a new romantic cycle. Something about an offer. Okay, that's interesting. Thank you. want this book to. It's so tiny. I love these cards. Should use them more. That's kind of a lot, though. I don't feel like that was the point. I'm going to put these down here, those cards. Well, what's happening there? Okay, I think I'm done. What is this for? Person's current feelings and thoughts. Yeah, I think I'm done. Okay. Okay, I'm back. Hi. Okay, so this is for your person, their current thoughts and feelings about you. Like right now, like in this time frame, whenever you watch this video, okay? So we have option one, it's the bee. Option two is the dolphin. Option three is the golden egg. Okay, so go ahead and make your choice, and I'm going to get started on option one. And there's timestamps below. Okay. Option one for their current thoughts and feelings about you from your person, the B. So I want to say this person might be busy working. Work, B's always make me think of work and being hard at work. Hold on, let me get comfortable. I told myself I would before I started, but I forgot. So sorry. So, anyways, right now, so this person, you might not be on their mind, I want to say. Maybe, but if not, they're busy working. So it's like, because we have King of Swords, they might not be talking to you very much. An organization in the corner. If King of Swords, in the upright, and then organization. Oh, but then underneath it, we have dream sweet, sleep deep. So this person might not be talking to you much. I have a feeling they're not, but that might be why you're looking into this. But we have the hummingbird with the sleep card. Making me think that they're definitely having some nice dreams about you with the moon card too. Okay. We got a lot of eights. I'm not sure. But I want to say that they want to offer, because we have the offering here. This is a lot coming in. We have a lot of cards for you, so this might be a while. Maybe a drink, okay, or a snack. Oh, and let me apologize in advance. I'm drinking soda, so I'm gonna burp a lot. I'm so sorry. I didn't think this through, and that's the only drink I got. Right? I mean, I got other ones, but I don't feel like getting them. And I can't cook tea now. Cook it, but you know what I mean. Whatever. We got the offering here. You see how it's someone making an offer, right? And then underneath it's the seed. So it's like an offer to start something with you. We have a new romantic cycle begins. So they might want to start something with you. And the offering with the seed is right underneath the Empress card. This is the lady, and the lady looks like she's giving an offering as well. And this is also the Ace of Swords with the King of Hearts. So basically, I feel like someone that, probably your person, the person in your love interest is the King of Hearts, They're the bee right now. They're the little busy bee. They definitely want to offer you something. And at the very least, I think the only thing that they can offer you right now is conversation. And I want to say it's with the next to the moon card. I don't, it's not necessarily stable conversation, because I want to say the Empress. So it's like they see you as someone that's, I want to say, dateable, okay? Because it's like a counter, you know what I mean, like a divine counterpartner, so to speak. So it's like they definitely see you as someone, someone that brights up their day. I want to say someone that grounds them too, okay? But they're going through something. We have the Death card and then the Seven of Pentacles. But it's that one where it's like it's a dead tree. So it's like, I feel like that's wrapping up some type of karmic cycle, waiting for something to finish, right? Working hard at something, okay? And we have the Three of Cups. But this Three of Cups isn't like, like a bunch of people and hanging out. This is like, I always say it's like one person with three cups and giving them all to one person. So it's like triple time, Something with the number three, because we do got the Empress. Empress always makes me think of the number three, someone might be a life path three, this person that you're looking into. They're definitely someone that's an opportunist, and they're looking for a great opportunity to give you a balanced offer that I want to say sparks, starts like hints towards romance. So you guys, I don't know what you guys are. Silence, though. I feel like you guys aren't talking right now.
So what are their current thoughts though? Is that they have a huge cup of love that they want to give to you. They might be someone that used to be single, like maybe they might have been involved in other situations or things like this. Like not really like in a mischievous way. They just might not have been non-committal. There you go. They might not have been very committal, but they definitely would, I feel like they want to commit to you. Then we got the Ace of Pentacles. So it's like that's more of like an offering, okay? Got a garden too. It makes me think of like a public offering. This is like handing over, you know what I mean? Lots of handing and giving. So it's like I feel like this person wants to, they're thinking about how. I want to say they look like they're thinking about how. Like this makes me think of like a bright idea, okay? But it's too bright. So earthworm, they're like grounding that shit, okay? Then I got the shark and I got the silence, I mean not the silence card, but the merchant card over here. So it's like seizing an opportunity, but next to the moon, not knowing when. So it's like they want to give you love, they want to give you something, I want to say to build on, like a seed, like the seed, okay? The backside of the King of Swords. Okay, because then we have the King of Swords over there in the upright. Yeah, this person's, I want to say this person's probably very hard to talk to. And they might not be talking to you right now. Or they might go through periods where they're not talking to you. I want to say they're working. Eight of Swords. I want to say they're not happy about not talking to you. King of Pentacles. Yeah, that's more like, because they're a very solid person at the end of the day, I want to say. Risk. I don't know. Healing and risk next to each other under moon right here. It says, learn to grow wherever you are planted. So this person, I want to say, takes a risk, takes risks. They're not afraid to because they feel like they can learn and adapt to any situation. That's with the merchant card too. So what they're thinking, I don't know. They're thinking something's not a risk. I mean, I guess making an offers to you are not risky. They're not making risky offers to you, I want to say. True healing of the mind, body, and soul. They're healing something secretly. Something with a death card, some type of transformation, okay? We got the Page of Wands. That's what, like I said, that's making like, what did I call them? Reckless offers? Risky offers. This person might not be afraid to make risky offers to you, but maybe lately they are. Maybe that's why you're looking at what they're looking into. Why you maybe that's why you're looking into the way they're feeling, because you're trying to figure out why they're not acting the same way they normally do. I want to say maybe because they got a crush on you. Okay, with that new romantic cycle, that's what I'm saying. So this literally might this is making me think that this is someone that I don't know. Maybe you guys got struck with Cupid's arrow or something. But they definitely see you as something worth pursuing. But they don't necessarily know how to pursue you. Bumbling, like bumblebees. They're kind of bumbling around with their offers. Like their offers aren't good. They're not solid. They're trying to offer you things. I want to say they feel like you have, like you're not seeing their offers and they're trying aggressively. So they should just show you. I want to say that they like you. Oh wow, and then we got the Emperor card, okay? And it's from the same deck, and I never use this deck. So, and they're really pretty. So the Emperor card with the Empress card from the same deck and the Ten of Cups underneath. You know, the Ten of Cups in this deck is full of strings. Lots of strings. So, and they all lock in to lock in all those cups. So I feel like they see you as definitely their counterpartner. So you could be a me you could be male or female because we got both pair on the table, okay? You both might be King of Swords, you know. This could be same sex too, but basically they see you as someone worth pursuing. Something's not lining up though, because this is like a black sun, and it's making me think of the Stag card because the Stag card has that sun in it too. And that's about, you know, the Stag card in the animals deck, it's kind of like being the man, being the head of the household, being the emperor, so to speak, you know. And basically their feelings towards you is that they see you as someone that could be their partner. This definitely could be same sex, because now I'm thinking about the stags. Okay. So strength card, that's definitely holding back. They haven't said any of this to you, and I don't think they plan on it. I don't know. But their current thoughts are that you're, you make them think bad things. Okay. That's with the moon card and the hummingbird, like I was saying, with a new romantic cycle beginning and silence. Oh God, the King of Swords again. How many people are we dealing with here? That's why I said this person might have been someone that has then been around, okay? They might have a lot of people in their life. And they also might be someone very hard to talk to. But it's like on and off, very hot and cold. Because we have King of Swords, okay? And then under that is the Hangman, okay? King of Swords, I'm talking. The backside of the King of Swords. I'm not talking. Front side of the King of Swords again. I'm talking. Okay. So next to this, how card here. So they seem to always want to spark a conversation with you. So they definitely think that you're someone worth talking to. Like I said, they see you as their match. There's not really much more I can say about that threshold. This is someone that likely wants to marry you. Or, and if they don't right now, they definitely will in the future. Okay? So their thoughts about you, or is they want to give you, I want to say they want to offer you everything. And they might even want to offer you some type of commitment. This is someone who is non-committal at the very least, and they want to offer you commitment because they see you as someone that they can match with to commit to. Maybe that's why they're non-committal, because they could never find anyone like that that matched to them. Okay? What do you need to release? Okay? So just makes me that always make that's making me think of an ex. Okay, if I'm thinking about romance, I want to say that they feel like you need to let something go in order for that to happen. Maybe they do. Someone needs to let something go. Maybe you both do. Usually when I go back and forth like that and I can't pin it down, like right away, I have the moon card. Okay, so I'm not quite sure here, but one of you has a lingering ex with all these kings here. My goodness, okay? Abundance. The goddess of abundance, divine, let me thrive, fortune be mine. So that's making me think, this always makes me think of analyzing things. And with the B, they might have, I want to say, an extensive past of dating, maybe not like literally going out necessarily, but like online dating, something like this. They've met a lot of people, I want to say, and none of them have really struck them the way you do. You make them almost behave differently than they should, because this is an emperor or empress at the end of the day, and their angle to approach you is the page, so that doesn't really quite line up, okay? So maybe you intimidate this person because, there is a back big king. Okay. So you might intimidate this person. But they definitely hold out because they have a desire for you. Okay. That they keep quiet. Something about an organization, maybe something with work. And then, but so yeah. And out of everything, yeah. You're something that they see. I don't know. They see something, some type of growth with you that they can, there's an abundance that can be had. Okay. They haven't made an offer to you, but I feel like they want, this is more of this, like male or female. Okay. My goodness. There's offers being made. Okay. So it's like, and this is the Ace of Cups with the Three of Cups. So it's almost like, ignoring those all those options and honing in on one specific one, and that's their I feel like they're what they're thinking is how to tell you this. Okay, the bouquet. They haven't given you this, but they want to give you. I want to say they want to knock on your door and give you some flowers. They must know where you live. But because hummingbird makes me think of flowers. Belladonna is our flower card over here, and it says silence. Listen more and be quiet. So yeah, this person's really quiet. This is like a secret admirer. They have a secret. They have a. They're like, yeah, this is a secret admirer. Oh, that's true. You got so many cards. Hold on. I'll finish with these. So they want to give you something, anything, a token of something. I'm not sure. They want to give you something, an offer. Because this is basically, this is this, right? And this is this. They want to give you something physical. So obviously, I think flowers because it's romance, but it could be anything. It could just be something verbal, but it's something in real life. I say face to face. That's what's making me think of face to face. This person, okay, they think you're very, I want to say, like reliable, consistent. You know, you're very. They see you as someone. They want to make an offer to you, because they see you as someone that is a good companion for them. Like honestly. With the Devil card next to the King of Swords, next to Strength, you know, these are all three from the same deck, and they all flew out at the same time. Okay, that's how you get extras, because more came out. So that right there tells me maybe they consider themselves to be someone that's very hard to deal with. And they see you as someone that can be that person. This person is probably someone who's always wanted a very committed relationship, but just never saw it happening. Enemy. This person might be seen as a lot of people's enemy for some reason. I don't know what makes me think of this. They might have a job. That's what it is. Organization. Okay. They have some type of job that's very organized. This is making me think of a police officer. Someone that's got, like, people just don't like them. They're not an enemy necessarily. They might be. That's why I said it could be any type of organization. It could be crime even. Organized crime. Okay. But no, I think it's more so something else, but it could be anything. But they work for some type of organization. Because of this card, I don't think, I don't know, whatever it is, it's something that they're very dedicated to. It's a full-time job, I want to say. It's a career. There you go. But so that could even be like a lawyer. You know what I mean? Like people that have like, people got a negative look on them. I think automatically was thinking police because the organization card is blue. But if not, but they're such a lover. I want to say they're not an enemy at all. They're such a sweet person. And they want to be your lover. I want to say they want to be your lover. They want to be your lover. I think it's so romantic. Oh, I feel like they're hoping they can give you an offer one day. So I want to say, I can't pinpoint a location on this person. Not that I ever really can, not like literally, not like that. But like, I don't know if they're in your area or if they're at a distance. But it's definitely someone that you talk to on and off. Okay, you might go through periods of not talking. It could be big or small, but during those periods, I feel like it's annoying on the both of you because we got the Eight of Swords here. All right, and then the Moon next to it, where it's the Eight of Hearts. It's like walking away. Like maybe you've tried to walk away from this person and not talk to them no more because of being confused. But no, their current thoughts about you are that I want to say they're very faithful to you. They're not your enemy. They're someone that wants to love you, and they hope you feel the same. Okay. And then we even got the Female Foe card. Okay. We got lots of duality here. Give me this. Okay. That's the male version and the female version of this. So you guys, I want to say, are the male version and the female version of each other. Okay. You know that expression, that's the female version of me, or that's the male, you know, things like that. You guys are a very good match, a very good pair. My cards, and I don't know what they're saying, because I don't know their spirituality, but my cards are saying you guys are a pair to be paired. Okay, these might even be pears, like the fruit. That's funny. I just purchased a couple pears at a garage sale. I was walking, I had to walk across town. Fuck, that was like a 45-minute walk. It was exhausting. I had to go pick up my mail from the last place I lived. And it was literally, it's like on the other side of town. My fucking God. I didn't realize what I was getting myself into that day. But, anyways, and it was hot as hell. I caught a tan just from walking. Anyway, sorry, sidetracked. Point is, at the garage sale, they were selling these cool little pear decoration thingies, and I decided to buy them. So, yeah, pears. Like, you guys are a pear, all right? I'm gonna say maybe you both can relate, male or female, whoever, whichever the viewer you, whoever you are, male or female, you're public enemy number one, no matter what you're doing. Like, everyone's wants your fucking head, I wanna say. Everyone is not, you know what I mean? People don't like your career. Something, okay? Drama follows you, I want to say. And it works both ways with y'all. That's what's making them. Yeah, I want to say maybe that's what this Page of Wands is. Maybe you both suck at making offers to each other, okay? Kindness. Oh, but you guys are probably really kind to each other, I want to say. You guys aren't foes to each other. There's, like I said, that risk card. They're not someone that's afraid of things. So it's like they don't really see you as a risk. So it's like you might think they see me as someone who's a foe or an enemy. No, they don't. And if you are, they're not afraid of you. Kindness. Take respite by a pond and be kind to yourself and others. They like the way you treat yourself, okay? And they just honestly, that makes me think of taking you on a date. They want to just take you somewhere and just be kind to you. I feel like with the dog card, the lover card, and the kindness card, fuck. And with bouquet, they just want to, yeah, they just want to be kind to you. That makes me think that maybe they know you've had a hard life or something and you haven't had a lot of kindness given to you because this dog is very, 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 what's faithful? Faithful. I was going to say loyal, but very faithful. But water represents emotions. And you see that little puddle there? It's like it's a dried out. It's not even like an oasis. It's not replenishing. It's kind of this, like, you know what I mean? This person. They're saying that you're someone that would stay with someone through very hard times, you know? You're very kind. They see that you're very kind. And they're thinking about that. And that's one of the reasons it's making them want to come in and romance you, okay? But they're hoping, you know, that in between the foe and the enemy is hope. So it's like they're hoping you don't see them as the devil, the swords, you know what I mean? This literally might be someone that, yeah, they definitely think you got a bad impression of them. That's why they're a secret admirer. But they don't know how to talk to you. Something about getting the fire put out. Like, God, they don't know. I'm gonna say with the bee and how bees bounce around to all different flowers. Yeah, this person has, I want to say this person's maybe never been married. This person never commits to anything. But God, do they want to commit to you? Okay, like we even have the lady and the gentleman. Look at all these pairs. You guys are too cute. Okay, and they're facing each other because if I put them like on my board, they're like, look, he wants to give you the cup and you want to take it. All right, so they want to give you the cup and you want to take it because I don't know who you are. This is so much. It could be you could be the masculine, you could be a feminine. I don't know what you are, right? But definitely got both sides working here. So, but yeah, there's kindness to be given to you from them. They want to be kind to you. Something with music. They might want to listen to music, just sit in the grass and listen to music with you and talk to you. I don't know, something about keeping you safe from risky things. Keeping you safe. They don't want, there's something in your life that they see as a risk. It could be a person. It could be whoever this past puddle is for, this little puddle in the background for. It could be your family. It could be something like this. It could be a relative. It could be that's the same thing as family, but it could be a past relationship, past lover that's now an enemy. Okay, and yeah, with enemy and foe, like maybe you guys are arguing. They see someone like that around you, and that's what's making me think the Page of Wands. Like they're definitely keeping their eye on that, and. Because they see them as someone that's a risk, and you're trying to heal from that, but you're not talking about it. They're not talking about it. This is a complete, you guys don't really talk about nothing, do you? Okay. Tree of Life, this person is your destiny, right? They're your destiny. You are destined to definitely have some type of relationship with them. Sexual? I don't know. It's got a lot of love, so it very well could be, all right? With pears, it's making me think someone's got a big booty. Got a thick, thick butt, all right? Tiger Lily, security. Choose a safe harbor for now. That's what I was talking about with the risk card. And the merchant on the harbor. So it's like, I want to say they're afraid to approach you and talk to you. They must know of where you live, where you are, how to find you. They must have a way to talk to you, you know, during this time. So I said this could be a period of not talking. They could be busy working, you know. So it could be like a day or two, or it could be even like a month or two. Like, it's been some time. Like, just, it's whatever time that isn't accustomed to you guys. Like, whatever's normal for y'all type of thing. Like, there's been some period of time that's kind of like normal. It happens routinely, I want to say. And it doesn't really, and with the hummingbird and the bee, they're kind of the freaking same thing, all right? They both kind of fly around and pollinate a bunch of different flowers. Third party pollinating. This person might be a doctor. Like someone that's like a gynecologist, I want to say. All right. Scientist, someone that does something. All right. But Tiger Lily, so they're not telling you this. Okay. True wisdom and making good choices in life. Their thoughts are that you're making good choices, and they're going to come in, and I want to say they're going to come in and try to light the fire, you know, instead of having it, something happen that put the fire out between you guys. Shitty offer, a bad decision, you know, something like this, a King of Swords in reverse moment, like, or upside down, backside, like, not the best conversation, like, something was not taken properly. There's some type of miscommunication going on between the two of you. But during this miscommunication, as I said, there was some type of fire brewing between y'all. Like, there was some type of smolder you guys could feel. All right? You probably felt it. They probably felt it. But because they're such a fucking player, all right? Because they're such a fucking player, they're non-committal. They're on date. I don't know what their deal is. They're just flying around and pollinating, all right? And just, that makes me think, because it's not literally actually the act of going and having sex with people. So they might just go around and e-date and flirt with people online and say a bunch of different things. And, you know what I mean? They'd be pollinating, but not literally in there pollinating. You know, it's something about third party pollinating. So like, that's masturbating, likely. Okay. So this person definitely gets around and has a sex drive. That's definitely, oh yeah, the hummingbird and bee, they have a very big sex drive. And I want to say they think about what kind of sex drive you might have. You got the moon card, they don't know your sex drive. And man, do they want to know. They want to start a new romantic cycle with you. Eight of swords, they're tied up. They're not able to with the strength. We got 3 8s, okay? That's more destiny. The destiny card is an 8 too. We have Tree of Life. So this is definitely someone that you're supposed to, with the Emperor and the Empress, it's all trees. So this is someone that you're supposed to know and get to know. Are you supposed to date and have some passion with them? I'm not sure. They might be someone that you're supposed to start a karmic cycle with. But I'm sorry. With the Emperor and the Empress card here and all the other pairings, I'm sorry. I'm thinking I'm going to call soulmate. All right. With faithfulness right in the middle. Yeah, no. Obviously, because not everybody's going to watch this reading and it's going to resonate. So for the ones that doesn't resonate, this is likely someone that's going to come in and look like they're going to be perfect for you. But for the majority of y'all, forget it. It's going to come by surprise. Okay? And it's definitely a good, it's not a risk, it's a good thing. It's a good relationship, I want to say. So that's what their thoughts are about you. That, like, they need to figure out how to cross the threshold, I'm going to say, cross the boundaries and give you a fucking solid offer so that you finally know what they want from you. So, because pears are, they're odd shaped, they're, you know what I mean, they're wonky. So it's like I want us to feel like whatever y'all have been feeling towards each other, I feel like y'all have been feeling the same exact things towards each other and doing the same exact things to each other. So that equals nothing. So like if one's silent, the other one is. And then if the other one is, the other one is. And then if one flirts, the other one flirts. And if it doesn't, I feel like y'all mirror each other. And if that's the case, this person specifically is trying to figure out how to break that cycle and not mirror and make a solid offer to you so that everything can be squared off and understood. And at the end of the day, that offer that they want to make to you is a commitment. They want to try to figure out a way to, and I feel like they've been thinking a long time about it. Like they might even have a plan. They're like, listen here, this is how it's going to work. I've been thinking long and hard about it type of business. So if that's the case, then, so be it. That sounds like a really nice relationship. I wish you the best. So I hope you enjoyed. Whew, and tell me if you liked it. And that was a lot of cards. So I'm sorry if it was long-winded. I hope y'all stayed to the end. And if not, that's okay. Bye. Okay, option two, the dolphin. So this is your person, their current thoughts and feelings towards you or about you. Okay, I want to start off by saying that they definitely think that you are someone really special. We have the Empress card over here. So I mix that with the dolphin. That's like the girl of my dreams. Okay, with the Ten of Cups underneath. Okay, you're someone that's fit with the hummingbird too. They're very exciting and they love it and they're thinking about that. They're thinking about, I want to say, your bright-eyed curiosity and excitement to things. Okay. Ace of Wands. Oh, this might be a new thought that they came about. All right. They might not have always felt this way. Basically, it's just kind of like being noticed, I want to say. I want to say they woke up one day and they had a boner for you. Like, literally. They might have had a message from you. They woke up one day and there was a message from you. And they were like, boner? I love that person. So maybe you recently just popped up in this person's life. For what reasons? I don't know. Maybe it was coincidence, something with an organization. Maybe you recently had to just make that organization makes me think of work, you know? So maybe you hadn't recently, you bumped into this person because of something with work. I don't know. But something, they woke up one day and things weren't the same anymore. Okay. You got the moon card. This person's totally crushing me. You can tell by how giggly I am. And because of the dolphin card, they see you as someone that's like the dolphins. So it's like if I'm talking to the dolphin right now, I'm a little giggly. Okay. So we got the moon card. So they find you to be very mysterious. Okay. But very fun and colorful. Talkative, I want to say very talkative because we got the King of Swords over there. But some good conversation, I want to say open-minded conver all sorts of conversations. Because this King of Swords, Hangman, that like you're not very you're not very pushy. Like this person's holding the sword and they can talk, 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 talk. This one, the sword's in front, it's kind of like blinding them, so it's like the sword's kind of taking control. So it's like you're in control of your you know what I mean? Like you talk a lot, but nothing bad. Then we have the Death card with the moon. Okay, so it's making me think of lots of Scorpio, lots of water. Okay, Scorpio and Pisces and Cancer. Hey, we got the Dolphin card. So you might be a water sign because this is their thoughts about you. And if you're not, they definitely see you as someone like a water sign. Very go with the flow, very emotional. And very logical, I want to say. So you, and with organization, hardworking, a new romantic cycle. I want to tell you next to the offer. I want to tell you that they want to tell you what they're thinking about is an offer about and how to be romantic with you. They want to be romantic with you. Okay, the King of Swords again. All right, Father of Swords. That card makes me laugh. Holy shit! Let's get his face. Yeah. Okay. This person is really, really, really strict, I want to say. Okay, this person has a very intense look, to say the least. I don't mean to laugh at them. They have a sword. Okay, they see you as someone. They see, okay, yeah, you have a colorful sword. So that's what I'm saying. You're able to talk about anything. Very open-minded. This person might be a little more reserved than you. Some of the things you say might make this person make that face, is my question, is my point. Like, you know what I mean? Like, they're thinking about that. The shock value. You got some shock to you. And they like it, though. I want to see they like it. I think it's funny because I can't stop laughing, so it's got to be. That's the Knight of Cups. It makes them just go crazy. Blow bubbles. This is my. I blow bubbles for you. I have nothing to give you but bubbles. I love you. Type of thing. Like, they just love it about you. Okay. Five of Pentacles. They're thinking about something, about being left in the cold, obviously, but like, it was in the reverse. So that makes me think of maybe a past situation you were in, and they think about it. Maybe because this is always about literally being left out in the cold. You know, you and maybe someone younger than you, your daughter, your son, you know, your child, basically. You and your child, you might not have been on it out in the cold. You might have been heading to that little lodge there, but that lodge is definitely not your lodge. You know, so it's like you were on some type of trip, and the lantern, even though that one's a candle, it still makes me think of the hermit card. So they definitely, they're thinking that you're so very hermity. They think you're someone that really likes pets, and they think that you're someone that would either make a great parent or you are a parent, and they see you as a good parent. You know, because next to this card, it's like they want to offer you things because they see that. And they, this is someone that knows maybe about any type of past situations you've ever been in that were, you know, like I want to say up in the air, and you were kind of alone in the situation. You didn't really have anybody. The Hunter makes me think of having good instincts. Okay, so they see you. That what are their thoughts about you? Is that you're I want to say that they think you got good aim. So if you actually hunt, they like it. If you play video games, they like that. That's what I'm saying. Like they like that you can shoot things. Okay, and they're thinking about that. They're thinking about your hunting skills, whatever those are, whether they're virtual or literal, and that you're kind of like a free spirit. They really don't know. Like you're like the dolphin. Like you're very hard to understand, I want to say, and they see they're thinking about how they think about how basically like you're running. I want to say you're running from something and running, and they're trying to run towards you, okay? And you're running from something. Are you running from this person? Maybe. But if you're not, because if you are, you know, but if you're not, they see you as someone that's running away from someone, that's for sure. Maybe a King of Swords in your life. Something with the Death card. So that's what I'm saying. With the Five of Pentacles and the Death card, there was some type of transformation that you got the short end of the stick on. And they're thinking about how I want to say how you got away from whatever that is. Whatever transformation you did in your life, they think about it. With the Death card again, that's true. You got two times death. Because we got this Death card. Okay. And then this Death card. So with the moon next to it, it's kind of like making me think of secrets. So it might be something that's like a secret. Not your, not necessarily. It could be something you keep secret, but this person knows it. Not because of spying. This is someone you've likely told. Okay. And if you have not, silence, you know, it's making me think that they somehow know and they haven't told you. You got the moon twice too. So we got lots of heavy fog, and there's heavy fog today, okay? Heavy fog in the area. Conclusions are within reach, okay? Full moon eclipse. So their current thoughts about you are that eventually the Hunter, eventually they're gonna figure you out. They're trying to figure you out so that they can make an appropriate offer to you because they see you as an empress. And when someone sees someone as an empress, that's like seeing them as, on a pedestal. And it's like you can't date someone that's on a pedestal. No, they can't. You cannot put someone there. So if they've put you on a pedestal, they cannot do that. They have to take you down. Okay, they have to knock you down a peg. They have to balance the situation. So maybe they've tried to date you and it didn't work out. It was maybe they wanted to very badly, but they didn't take time to breathe out. That makes me think that they've tried to approach you and they have not. So this is someone that's tried to approach you in the past but has not. That's the death card. And then they try again, they get the death card. The moon card, it's like the more they get to know about you, the more they're able to come closer to I want to say finding the right opportunity to finally turn this romantic cycle into something good. The right offer. A hunter that's thinking about the senses and opportunities, like they're actively hunting opportunities to bring this to something. Because his conclusions are within reach. It's like they're getting fed up, I want to say, with everything. And expect a powerful change. That's always the truth shall be revealed card. Okay, the sun is right behind that shit. Something's been hiding the truth from you. They have been for some reason, and they're about to just, I want to say, go all out with the risk card. They're going to take a risk and they're going to learn to grow wherever they're planted. But no, like they're just going to go for it. And they're going to tell you. Harmony. They think that you're very harmonious. So that's more with the dolphin energy. Like they think that you would, that makes me think of making a great wife or husband. You know what I mean? Like you guys would, they think that you guys would be able to, I want to say coexist. That's a little cold though, but could be, But they definitely feel like you guys would make a happy home together. Okay. Maybe you've tried a couple times in the past. I don't know. They see you as their empress, which is basically saying that like that's your spiritual spouse. We got the moon card three times. How many times can you get the moon card? That's more running away too. So running away and being very secretive, okay? I'm not sure, but definitely triple layer now. We got three times the fog. So you've been in you, that's why you're probably looking into their current thoughts and feelings about you because they've been keeping you in the fucking dark. They haven't been telling you a damn thing. All right. You are my lady. Yeah. They definitely see you as their girl, their lady, their boo, whatever. Their boo. All right. They think you as, you know what I mean? They think you're, they love, they're chasing, they're hunt, they're looking for you. Like you're what they've been looking for. And I want to say they've been looking for you. They lost you. This is maybe someone that you don't talk to anymore with the silence card. Yeah. I want to say you don't talk to them no more. Some type of misfortune. So this might have been someone that had a lot of money and then they lost their money. Okay. So this their thoughts and feelings about you of how you're gonna view their finances. They're worried that you maybe you have more finances than them. I don't know. They're thinking about your finances and it makes them they want I don't know, they either want to know about your finances or there's something going on with their finances that they want to tell you about, or maybe because I told you we've got triple layer moons here, I might be busting out some secrets, right? So they might have found you, and they might have been wanting to give you an offer. They might have been hunting you down, found you somehow. Maybe your social medias, maybe like anything, and they want to come in and give you love, but they haven't. And they're not. They're waiting for some type of opportunity. I want to say something with their fortune, something with their money. They've been hiding it from you. I want to say because they think that you'll judge them because this woman obviously has money. And if they have no money and someone does have money, the person without money is always going to feel judged because that's how society tries to make people feel. So whether you have money or not, this person is insecure about their finances. So this is really blocking them from talking to you. Okay. Learn. Take a lesson from the owls. Deeply observe the night and you'll become a little wiser in the day. Yeah. This is someone that thinks about you, I want to say, every night. Okay. They might see you somehow daily, somehow. I'm not sure. Okay. But they have the ability to see you somehow. And they want to come in and give you conclusions, and they're gonna make a change soon. One day. This is making me think, one of these days, okay? One day I'm gonna seize the opportunity, okay? One day I'm gonna break the silence. One day I'm gonna take the risk and I'm gonna talk to them. Talk to them. Oh, wow, and look what's right underneath. We got the Queen of Hearts and the King of Hearts. So yeah, this person definitely thinks you're just adorable and great for the home, like really loving. I think you guys would get along very good intuitively. Owls and dolphins. Dolphins are very intuitive. So it's like all those animals talk to each other. This person must have a, they like your intuition and they think about your intuition. They might try to intuitively talk to you somehow. With the moon card too, that's a lot of water. That's a lot of intuition. So this person, protection. With that sword, they want to protect you. What are they thinking about with their with the protection? They're thinking about learning protection. So maybe they went off to go for some type of protection. Conserve what you have, save a little. That's what the finances. Maybe someone took this person's finances and they learned a lesson, I want to say, and now they're protecting themselves. So they're, but I want to say that makes me think that they're saying that they don't have money right now, but they're fully capable of obtaining money. They're the hunter. They can hunter get. They can work. They can do whatever. They have a trade skill. They have a way to make money. They have a job. I don't know, but they're protecting their finances now. So like they're saving them. So their thoughts about you, I want to say, if that relates to you, is that they learned that you're very, they learned about something with your finances, and it's made them feel more secure. They feel like you're not after their finances. If this is someone that has a lot of finances, they feel very, they feel like they don't need to protect themselves against their finances. I mean, against they don't feel like, well, hold up. They don't need to protect their finances against you. Like, you're not after their finances. With the Hunter card, that makes me think that like, you both are people that aren't really necessarily too financially driven. With Harmony, too, and the Dolphin, it's like, you'll probably just get the money you need. And I mean, like, you focus on the things that don't even cost money. Maybe. That might be something. I got water. That's the last card. So work with the elements of water for healing, purification, and refinement. And then we actually have the healing card in the same deck. It says true healing of the mind, body, and soul. So with the moon card times three and the king of swords times two, all right, with the ace of swords, this person is definitely going through it during this silence. They're organizing a way, they're trying to find a way to I want to say pop up and surprise you. A way that won't make you scare off. All right? But they see you in life and they want to speak to you. They want to clear the air because we've got three times the moon. They know that you have absolutely no idea. You have no idea about this person, okay? They've made a they there's something about a transformation that's taken place. The moon changes slightly. We have the moon so many times here, so it's like the, many moons, many moons. This is someone that you have not seen in many, many moons. Okay, so maybe like 10 moons time, you know what I mean? Like moons, lots of moons have gone by, like maybe like a year or two, who knows? Moon cycles have passed, okay. Lives have changed. Five of Pentacles has happened in your life since the last time you've seen this person, okay? that you don't know this person. You probably don't know this person knows any of this about you. This person knows triple time. This person knows anything that you don't talk about. This person knows. This person basically knows everything about you. This makes me think that they've hired a private detective on you. Okay. And they've like located you and they want to approach you. Conversation in reverse, silence. So yeah, they haven't said anything. And we have this. This is like waiting for the opportunity. All right. But the merchant, he can be seen as a bad person, you know, an opportunist. So it's like they're worried you're going to see them as a bad person. All right. Protection. You're going to want to protect yourself against them. Hunter, you might even want to shoot them or hit them or attack them. Okay. Or run away from them because you might be someone that runs away. But they really just want to give you a cup of love. Okay. So are they ever going to do this? I don't know. Are they ever going to get a hold of you? I want to say they are eventually because we got the King of Swords with the Ace of Wands. So it's like one day they are going to give you an offer. Are they someone you want an offer from? I have no idea. I really don't know. But this is that person's current thoughts and feelings about you. They definitely want something with you. So I hope you enjoyed, and I hope that was good. Okay, let me get a swig. All right. Option three for this is for your person, their current thoughts and feelings about you. Option three, the golden egg. This one's really pretty. Who knows what kind of animal's in there, right? It could just be a human. It could be a bug, right? But it's golden. So this person's thought, your person, and their thoughts and feelings about you. I want to say a golden opportunity. What about a golden opportunity? I don't freaking know yet. We got the golden egg and the merchant who's like, you know, an opportunist. And they go shiesty, those merchants. We got the offering, okay, with the seed underneath. So this is, they definitely are thinking about, got a new romantic cycle. They're afraid to start a romantic cycle with you, but they want to. Golden egg. They see you as something golden, like something, like even though they're not ready to, like this might not be someone that's ready to date. We have Eight of Swords, okay, with the Moon card. And with the Moon card, it's the, sorry, fixing this. It's the Ace of Cups. So it's like walking away from some heartbreak or some sad emotional situation, right? Walking off to become the hermit, I want to say. So this person has done that. And they might not be someone that was even trying to date or wanting to date, but they bumped into you, Bella, Belladonna. All right, silence. Listen more and be quiet. This person likes to be very quiet, but they think you're absolutely beautiful. Okay? But they're trying to heal. They don't discuss this, but they're healing from some type of thing that they've walked away. And a new romantic cycle, I feel like, is unfolding right before their eyes with you. They see that with you. They see a possibility with you, but they don't think they're ready. We got the Death card with the Ace of Swords, with the Eight of Swords too, and the King of Swords. This person's trying to just have a friendship. I want to say trying to keep it just intellectual. Okay, the Empress though, they can't. It's bothering them because they see you as someone just I want to say someone that's just perfect for them, someone that's absolutely balanced. Like I'm almost hearing like, why couldn't we have found each other before so this happened that made me have to heal? Like why couldn't we have dated that person instead of you? Like yeah, this person has regret even. That's what it's making me feel. They have some type of regret, at least a little bit of it. They might not be someone that regrets things, but they definitely feel like fuck, their hands are tied. They want to offer you, they want the golden egg. They see you as their golden egg, as a golden egg for them. But I don't know if they're actually going to say anything to you. Okay, I got the King of Swords in reverse. Okay. So, no, queen, excuse me. Queen of Swords. So we have the King of Swords over there in the upright, and then the Queen of Swords in the back. So, yeah, I want to say that they've dealt with whoever their past partner was. They were definitely someone that didn't really give them opportunities, someone that didn't talk to them, right? This person's definitely worried that if they don't speak up soon and make an offer to you soon, this is a worry of theirs, that you're gonna, I want to say, meet someone else, and maybe you'll even stop talking to them. Even if you don't meet someone else, you might just stop talking to them and go try to find a new romantic cycle. The Sun card. Okay, they definitely want to tell you this. They want to, they don't, with the back end of the Queen and the Sun, they see you as, I want to say, their counterpartner, because it's the King of Swords and the Queen of Swords, but you're not seeing them that way. Maybe they're not telling you that they see you this way, so you don't see them that way. Maybe they've given you an impression that makes you think that they're not interested. We have the Death card. They might have given you some type of impression, okay? And now you see it as, okay, well, I'm gonna go look elsewhere. And maybe you don't talk to this person that much anymore. There's the ice here. And you might be very cold with them. You're not being very warm and romantic and I want to say flirtatious or anything. Maybe you used to be and you stopped that. But if you did, it was likely because you felt like they were being too King of Swords with you. Okay. So what is this? The Four of Wands. Okay. Come on now. This is someone that really, really, really desires you sexually. They see you as someone that's definitely someone that they could, I want to say, have a really good time with. And because that's about the passion. Having it mean something, having it be balanced, you know? Like the 11-11 card, soulmates and things like this. So it's like, they want to say that you're turning your back on them. They're thinking about how, like, what that you've turned your back, kind of. You've turned cold on them. And they're trying to figure out how to turn you warm again. They want you to shine warmth on them, not cold. They're trying to figure out how to get back that passion and have it be balanced. So maybe you've already attempted to make flirts with this person, and hummingbird, it might have been really quick and fleeting and nothing too serious, but it definitely it scared them. I want to say it triggered them, and they might have went quiet on you, and then you were like, oh, well, then maybe they're not interested. Death card. Okay, we got death card twice again. So it's like with all that fog, okay? So they're definitely afraid to tell you the truth. And what they're thinking about that transformation. Like something happened that transformed, that made you treat them differently. And they're trying to figure out how to regain that and go back. Like they realize that they did something to you that caused you to change the way y'all's relationship was flowing. Because maybe this person thought y'all were having a new romantic cycle together. Because they see you as an empress. Okay. They see you as the emperor slash empress. They see you as somebody that they're trying to date. But then something happens where you went icy. And they're like, no, I want the Sun card back. You know, I want the Sun. I want that good passion. Like that everyone seeks. I want that back. We were having that. What happened? Why did it die? What happened? You know? And they're like, what can I do to change that? And I feel like they got in over their head. Like you were a lot deeper than they thought. They might have misread you. They definitely like you. Misread you or not, they like what you give. They like what you offer. You have a sense of mystery to you. You have even like a sense of, I want to say, like a chip on your shoulder. Like you've walked away from things. You've seen, you've had hard times. You've experienced Eight of Swords moments. You've experienced the Death card in your life. You're someone that's grown. Like you're a full grown fucking tree, I want to say. You're what everyone wants. You're a fully mature tree that produces apples, you know, you produced fruit, you harvest, you know what I mean? Like your 10 of cups organization, you've worked towards this. All right. So they see that now. They see that you're a lot deeper than they thought. They have the wrong impression with the moon card here, okay? So now I feel like they want to make a more straightforward offer to you. They want to change. They want to melt the ice, okay? They want you to melt the ice with them. So your commitment is being tested. So breaking the ice, this might even be someone that doesn't talk to you. This might be someone that just sees you floating by, passerbyer, okay? Conversation in reverse. It could be someone you've never even spoken with that we're talking about here. I know you might have picked a person in particular, but what comes through is what comes through. Because we got the ocean card, you know? I see as you're there's so much to you that they have no idea. Clearing the fog, death card. So this death, you know, whatever it was, it cleared the air. I want to say you cleared the air. You cleared the air on the situation and you put it where it belonged and you realized that you didn't want to give love to it. Because I want to say, why would you do that? Because you didn't think that they liked you. And maybe they didn't. And maybe now they realize they do. And they're like, well, how can I, you know, if it's kind of like, if you liked me once before, surely they'll still like me now. So maybe I just got to figure out I got to come up with an idea on how to. I gotta take a risk. I gotta figure this out. Okay. Your commitment is being tested. So I wanna say they were testing your commitment and you didn't test back. You're like, listen, I'm a grown ass tree. I'm a grown ass empress. I'm a grown ass emperor. I don't get tested. You don't test me. If you're someone that goes around testing people, then you're not in my league and the discussion. There's no need to test nobody here. You're to a point where it's like I want to say you're above and beyond such things, and this person, I want to say they regret it. Romance. They're thinking about how to romance you. They see you as a romantic interest, okay? Fertility in reverse. That makes me think that they feel like they fucked it up, all right? Y'all might have been like on the fast track to fuckville. Okay. Okay, because if you're an empress, you know what you want. If you're an emperor, four of wands, all right. The flower, all right, fertility. This has been discussed. The golden egg, the act of conceiving, right? All right. The offer, that offer has been on the, I want to say that offer was on the table and you took it away. Why did you take it away? I'm on your side at the end of the day. You're my viewer. You know what I mean? You're looking at my cards here with me. You came to me. So why did you turn your back on them? Obviously, because they weren't living up to the expectation. You're looking for the emperor. If you're an empress, you're looking for the emperor. If you're the emperor, you're looking for an empress. They weren't giving you offers. They were not giving you what you feel like you are giving capable of giving back, what you were giving to them. There was an imbalance, and it was like, forget it. The fertility in reverse card, like I'm not interested no more. Cold shoulder. Moving on, going somewhere else, someone that does, like trying to find that. And this person I feel like is telling you, hold the phone. You are golden. I need to get my shit together because you are someone that I want to settle down with, I want to say. Whether they want to have babies with you or not, they definitely see you as their four of wands situation. Love, okay? This person's in love with you. Love, fertility, and romance. And your commitment is being tested. They tested your commitment because they want to commit to you. This person's obviously got commitment issues. If they test your commitment, that makes me think I will give them the benefit of the doubt because they are someone that you have looked into. You might have turned your back on them, but they were someone that you looked at. So I won't shoot them away right away. They seem to be extremely romantic. No one say they're extremely horny and loving. They are this. They want to offer you these things. They want to offer you sex, romance, love. I want to say they want to offer you everything. They see you as the golden, like, you know what I mean? Like, you're what people, you know, in their opinions, in their perspective, you're what people seek. You're what they've been seeking. And they see it as they're gonna miss out on you. The bear card, 10 of wands. Okay. So they feel on it, and then they I want to say that they might have tried to walk away from you, but then they got guided right back to you. Golden egg. I want to say that they don't need much persuading. They don't need to be guided too hard back to you. The gentleman, this is the bashful gentleman, so it's like being shy. So they might feel some type of, like I said, a really deep-seated pull to you. I want to say to even maybe conceive with you and have babies with you. So use protection if you ever sleep with this person, okay? Use protection. Even if you have sex in the water. With the ocean card, that makes me think of y'all might have some hot tub sex or bath sex or beach sex, something in the water. That ain't that it. That's you could it could still happen. Make sure you're protected somehow, because babies are definitely with the egg, golden egg, and fertility, and romance and love. Okay, someone popped tequila. There's babies about to happen. I mean, things are going down. Y'all might want to even drink and have babies. Not literally, but I mean. So my point is that. At the end of the day, they are the gentleman, but they're a bashful gentleman. So I just don't think they were ready for you. And you came in like, pow. And you were like, no, you're not ready. I'm out of here. And they're like, okay, that's fine. And then they sat back and they're like, wait a minute. I kind of, whether I'm ready or not, I don't want to miss this opportunity. I got to make an offer to them. So it's being sick in bed. Like, they're sick of it. I want to say they're sick of it. Something is stressing them out. They're, like I said, they're sick of, I want to say, thinking about you constantly. The bear card's making me think that they're burdened with lots of thoughts about you and synchronicities, I want to say. And things that are making them constantly think about you, like they want, like they see you everywhere they go type of vibe. Okay? Patience in reverse. That's what all my cards were in reverse. No. So, they definitely... They're trying to be patient. I want to say you've been patient too. They're thinking about how patient you've been with them. I want to say that they cannot believe that they didn't notice you. I want to say they let their past get cloud their judgment. Breathe with patience underneath. So they're telling you they're thinking they're like, okay, they're in a state of be calm down. Rest for a minute. Calm down, rest, and just let it be, okay? This is someone if I'm speaking for them, they're like, okay, I just got to calm down, maybe take a nap and maybe eat something. I just got to relax, okay? This person's really deep and they're very understanding. I'm guided to them for a reason. So if that's the case, then likely, you know what I mean, they feel the same way for me. And they've been just maybe they didn't know because I didn't tell them. And I tested their commitment, but that's because I do that with everybody. I test everyone that I meet because I got issues, all right? Because of stuff that's happened to me in the past. And I'm pissed that I let those issues let me miss an opportunity with someone that I considered to be perfect for me. I let those issues get in my way. They clouded my judgment. And now I'm just stuck sitting here sleeping alone, and they're out trying to find someone to be their great match. And I feel like I am that match, and I need to tell them somehow. Okay. End of channel, end of transmission. Okay. Rejuvenation, reawaken and stand stronger. So they might be sleeping literally right now, because this is about like their energy right now. So this might be someone that's sleeping, but they're definitely, I want to say, in a moment of silence. Listen more and quiet be. All right. Listen more and be quiet is what I always read it at, but listen more and quiet be. So they're trying to really think and go in deep. And I want to say they're thinking and going in deep, and they're trying to find a way to make an offer to you. They feel like you're going to accept it very logically. You're not going to see the warmth in it. They're worried that you're not going to see that they like you. Like, I feel like this person feels like they burned their bridge with you. They missed their shot with you, and they're still gonna fucking do it. And they're gonna try to make a romantic cycle with you, even though they feel like they somehow they're hoping that you feel the same about them, because they feel so strong about you and your relationship with them that they tell themselves, if that is who that is for me, then they're gonna understand and come back. They will melt the ice. They've only put up the ice because of me. So if I clear the air and let them know where I'm coming from, that ice should melt. I'm hoping I'm not too late, but they might be. I don't know. Dragonfly, you bring light to this world, so you're someone that attracts a lot of attention. Dragonfly, this person feels like they're part of your soul family, I want to say. They feel connected to you. And they see you as something very precious and something that they can start new romance with. Like they were hung up on old romance, I want to say, an old missed opportunity or something. They were looking at it and they missed an offer that you gave them, and they're like, hold the phone, hold on, oh my God, no. And that's what they're thinking about. That's their thoughts about you right now. Their main thoughts is of love, fertility, romance. So I want to say that they don't tell you, they're bashful, they're shy. Something about a risk. They're afraid to take the risk to tell you that. Their commitment, I want to say, with this your commitment being tested card, I want to say this is their commitment being tested to their own happiness. They see fulfillment and happiness in you. They see all that. They see Four of Wands with you. Okay. But they feel like they fucked it up. And now this is like destiny putting the pressure on them to test their commitment to fulfilling their own destiny and happiness. Are they going to let it pass them by, or are they going to speak up and try to talk to you? Did they miss their opportunity? Either way, it's a risk that they have to work through healing. It's something that they struggle with. Okay. With organization, it might have been just because of something with the way they were raised, you know. But either way, with the malady, with health card, and patience and breathing and rejuvenation, this person's definitely likely sleeping right now. And they might be having dreams about you. And they're just trying to, I want to say, piece it all together. And they feel rushed because they don't know about your romantic interests. They don't know if you're single. They don't know if you're mingling. They don't know if you've started something new with someone, you know. You might not be talking to this person fully and totally, like often enough, and or maybe they're just not in your personal business like that. But they feel like they're not fully in the light with you, and they feel like you're someone that definitely speaks the truth. We have the Sun card, and we have you bring light to this world. So that's literally like you definitely clear the air on things. So silence, there's been silence, and whether it's because of them or you, but they definitely want to try to take a risk and I want to say express somehow with an offer. They want to make an offer. I want to say a really small fucking offer. That little itty bitty. It's a pearl though. It's a good offer. It's a pretty offer. It's mother of pearls. Pearls are really nice. They're smart. They're wise. Like they're trying to think of the best fucking offer they can make you. That will cause the ripple effect that will lead to reversing this, I want to say, and bringing back the love, bringing back the passion, bringing back some romance that you guys were having. You know, they don't want to hide behind any more masks. You know, like I feel like this person put on a mask for you. Like you came at them maybe, and then they put a mask on, like, no, not interested. And you're like, oh, all right then. And that was like part of their game. Whether they knew it or not, they were playing a game with you. And you weren't about to play that game. Why? Because, all right, do I need to remind you? You're a grown ass person. you don't play those games. You might have used to when you were that age, when you were 10, 15, 20, 25. You know, when you were younger, you might have played those types of games. But you're like, no, you don't do that no more. And that shit, I want to say, threw this person through a crazy loop. And they realized this person's not like anyone else I've ever dated. I need to figure out how to transform this. And that's what they're thinking about. Okay. It's my breathing app. It's telling me to breathe right now. So yeah, maybe this person recently just recently woke up and they're thinking, but they're definitely that you're definitely heavy on their mind, and it's all about an opportunity that they feel like they've missed, and they're trying to figure out how to maybe not miss it, have change that. Right? But they're at a period of stopping and thinking and rejuvenation and healing. So it's like this person, will they come forward? Will they actually express what they want to say to you? I'm not sure, but they definitely want to. Okay, you're someone that they wanna. They see you as you're like their pair, you're their twin, you're their match. You know, ten of burdens, man. I mean, ten of burdens, ten of wands. Phew. They wanna. There's lots of sexual passion there. So this person's definitely feeling like they missed out, and. Oh, I don't know whether they did or didn't. That's something you know. So I hope you enjoyed, and I hope you have a great day. Okay, bye.